is going to kick off a breathtakingly ambitious campaign to return samples from Mars to Earth. And as an astrobiologist who spends my life working on biosignatures, there could be nothing better. So just to understand, you know, most of what we do now is we try to work with data that's coming back from orbiters, coming back from rovers, and the idea of having actual samples from Mars that have been carefully selected and returned to our planet and our laboratories where we can scour them and hit them with everything we've got, I mean, it's just going to be a huge paradigm shift for the kind of work we do. Plenty of amazing things that this mission could discover. But like every astrobiologist you ask, I'm going to say, of course, evidence for life. And I guess I should qualify that. Like there are different types of life. We could find evidence for ancestrally related life, the same kind of life we have here on Earth that perhaps we just caught from the next planet over. And of course, that would be tremendously exciting in its own right. It would give us a chance to replay the tape of evolution on another planet and rerun that experiment and see what turns out. But what gets me most excited is this idea of an independent genesis, a kind of life that's unlike any life that we've ever seen before. And specifically, when I think about the work that my group does, we're really interested in this idea of agnostic biosignatures, or a type of like evidence for life that doesn't presuppose the same molecular framework as life here on Earth or the same underlying biochemistry. And sometimes it feels like trying to imagine a color that you've never seen before. You know, figuring out ways that we could look for chemical complexity or unexpected accumulations of elements or isotopes that would be suggestive of a life that could be just completely different from anything we'd seen before. And I just think that would be better than really any other discovery in the history of modern science.